Now to housing project. The Lagos State Mortgage Board has held its fourth stakeholders forum on maintenance and safety at the Anthony Anahoro Housing Scheme, Ogba, where the general manager of the State Mortgage Board, Mr. Baiwa Forsyth, educated beneficiaries of the scheme on the need to make their insurance payment promptly. Ogba is one of the areas where the Lagos Home Scheme is located in the state. The Anthony Anahoro Housing Estate was commissioned in 2015 during the administration of Governor Babatunde Fashola, an initiative designed to reduce the housing deficit in Lagos State. 6 years gone, beneficiaries of the scheme have taken ownership of their property.
You have to do something else away from the kitchen. Never wear loose clothes.
And the State Mortgage Board is here to educate them on maintenance, safety, as well as the process of repayment plan.
Your repayment is very, very key. Very important. No matter what the situation may be. And that is why we have brought these stakeholders to you. Though we understand that most residents here have probably 36, 40 months to go. You started a race. It is not the person who starts that race that is the winner. It's the one who ends that race. So suffice to say that whatever it is, challenges here, my sister here mentioned NSAS, COVID-19, we understand all that. But it's important that every day you look at that property and look at what the government has done. You can't compare it, you know, what we started in 2014 to what was obtainable before. Look at it. It's standing right in front of you. Everybody wants it. And there's obviously a deficit. The deficit is over 4 million. So I want you to guide it judiciously. You have the race that is left. It's not that much. Whatever it is, everybody has their personal issues. It doesn't mean if you are missing out on 3 payments, 2 payments, you can't come and redeem it. You can. Even we have people who are obviously over the 3 months period. We call them, listen, come into our office, we cancel you. Because you know the economy, we understand. But what we want for you is the best. We don't want to come in here and say 3 months, we take you to arbitration and collect these houses. Because obviously, once we collect, you can't sell it at that price anymore. It's going to be more. But if you benefit from it, because some people at that time, it was 30%. Now we're doing the rent to own 5%. But 30%, you had to come up with that 30% of 10 million, of 17 million. It's so much. The other advice is also the issue of insurance. If you are making repayments and you are not paying insurance, it's as if you're just going to third mainland bridge and throw your money into the lagoon. Because it's very, very key.
One crucial aspect of the scheme is insurance payment for the property, which is for a period of 10 years, and those in charge of the policy explains the need for prompt payment.
Why it is important to take insurance seriously, no matter how hard it bites. I know sometimes, of course, a lot of us would have felt, it's not easy, Jare. I'll be careful on the road. I just brought a car, I'll be careful. All these damper drivers, I know their routes, I'll not pass their routes. I know that no matter how careful you may be, there are risks everywhere. There are risks everywhere. By the special grace of God, you will be full owners of these homes at the end of your 10 years. Don't say, I'm off Lagos Homes hooks. They will not be debiting my account again. Don't stop there. Be encouraged to continue. Be encouraged to continue because nobody knows.
Another vital issue touched is safety and fire prevention.
Wrong installation of gas cylinders. Cylinders are never meant to be in your apartment. Cylinders are meant to be outside your apartment. The reason is because fire does not start from cylinder. Fire starts from burner. And if you have your burner separated from your cylinder, in case of fire, you can quickly rush to where you have your valve and shut the supply of gas. To an extent, you have disarmed the fire. Unlike a situation where you have it right in the kitchen, you have no access to it, and you can't stop it from finding its way into the fire. That is more disastrous. Use of candle. You know, when I was much more younger, so many houses in Lagos were raised down by candle. And to me, I don't think it's no longer economical. Unlike the candle we have in the past, you can use one for 3 weeks, 1 month. But now, just one in the next 2-3 hours. is gone. So it's no longer economical. And we have rechargeable lanterns, we have inverters, and those things that were not in existence in those days. So you can make use of any of them. Also, we discourage the use of boiling ring. The boiling ring, it doesn't have control. So anything that you can't control, you know, no one is above mistake. You can forget. But whatever you will forget and will cost you your property or your what you have gotten with your hard-earned income, we tell you to do away without it. Also, fueling generator. You are encouraged not to fuel a working generator. A lot of us do that. For those of us who like football matches, African Magic, Telemundo, you don't want to miss any part. And you want to fuel a generator that is working. Before, if you want to put on a generator, the first thing you do is you check the state of the fuel, if it's going to be sufficient for the period or for the hours you want to use it. If it's not sufficient, you top it up. Then, apart from that, I told us for fire to happen, three things must be present. If you want to fuel a generator, you're already carrying fuel. The exhaust of the generator, what is that? So where do we have oxygen? It's present in the air. You know, when you are fueling a generator, you only target the liquid content. PMS products are the kind of fume that comes out like gas. If the fume could just get to where you have your exhaust, it's going to result in fire. So that is the reason why you don't fuel a working generator. And in case you find yourself in a way where a strange alarm is being triggered, please leave the building immediately. Get to the reception. Find out the situation of things. And don't return back to the room until the alarm is off. You use extinguisher with the acronym called PASS. P-A-S-S. P-A-S-S. The P stands for pull the pin. That is what is called the pin, the safety pin. If you have a safety pin there, if you press the extinguisher from today till tomorrow, the content will not discharge. So for you to use extinguisher, you pull the pin. You remove that pin. You remove that pin. And after that, aim at the seat of the fire. You don't fight flame and you don't fight smoke. If you fight flame and smoke, you exhaust the whole content of the extinguisher and the fire will still be there. Then after that, squeeze the lever. That angle where you are lifting from is referred to as the lever. So you press together for the contents to discharge. And after that, you sweep from side to side so that you can cover the whole of the fire.
Then the fire extinguisher drill in case of any ugly incident. The general manager of the State Mortgage Board also used the opportunity to assure interested individuals of more housing schemes across the state.
So we have come here to let them know the importance of that repayment, the importance of repaying as at when due, the importance of insurance, the importance of making sure that the environment is very, very clean, sane enough for inhabitants. So basically, it's that message we have brought to them. And we made it very, very important to make them understand that the fact that these repayments are made gives other people opportunity to benefit from what the government is doing. For example, in the next couple of weeks, 480 units will be commissioned by Mr. Governor at Ikorodu Ibeshe. We're looking forward to another 660 in Agbowa Odonosa. We're also looking forward to 744 units in Shongotedo. All these payments goes into a dedicated account where the government will use, you know, to make further constructions for the people. So we have actually come here to tell them and let them know that these payments are very important.
This is the fourth housing scheme visited by the Lagos State Mortgage Board, and government says it will continue to engage allottees on maintenance and safety as more schemes will be rolled out for residents.